car.
Yeah, we're rolling.
Okay. So, of course, I know your name, but for the tape, if you wouldn't mind telling me your first and last name.
Michael Richardson.
Thank you. So, your thoughts. I know you did a little research on this proposal. What do you think about the bill?
I think it's better late than never. I support it. I want to be on the ground level of it because I don't never want another parent to ever suffer from being told their daughter was released at 12:37 in the morning and found in dismemberment about two blocks from the police station that let her out and said that she was still in the precinct. At the time her mother called, it said she was still there and she was safe. She was released out at 12:37 in the morning with no purse, no cell phone, and we found her dismembered 11 months later, right down the street from the same jail facility that assured her she was fantastic.
Mm. What do you think happened?
You know, right now with all the inconsistencies in the report from the sheriff's and the OR report that was revised multiple times, we are now seeking to do a grand jury and ask that these people give their testimony again to the grand jury. And then we'll play the process of elimination. Right now, it brings up too many evil thoughts of what could have happened. And with a grand jury getting involved and seeking indictment for the people that were involved, it'll come out. It'll come out. A lot of people think this family has been resting on that story, but we've just been working closely with people that know what our next move should be.
Wasn't there a settlement?
Yes, it was.
And so doesn't that preclude you from, or would it be a civil suit?
No. This is not about suing. This is about, one thing I love about California in this capacity, there is no statute of limitation to murder. And we do believe, and we have enough evidence to know that it was murder.
Mm-hmm. So you want to go after whoever was responsible?
I want to get some additional answers that they were protected and not to have to state that what happened on the night of Mitrice's disappearance. Mm-hmm. And there's too many inconsistencies, and we need to get to the bottom of it. And, you know, I anything that I could do in this day and age to help a parent keep their child, even working with St. Jude Hospital, giving donations as opposed to PETA. I mean, everybody think their pet is family, but these are lives. These are people that's losing their children. And to be a parent that lost their children, I never, ever wanted. And you would think with all the senators that we have that something like this would be top priority, with a no-brainer, but they're busy trying to get votes by passing out turkeys and doing hams and stuff like that. Whereas these are the things that we vote them in for. This stuff right here, this matters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's go back to the bill. Why do you think it would change? Why do you think it would help change the situation?
Well, with my 20 plus years working in the medical field, we do not release patients that do not have an address. We do not release patients that, you know, pose a threat to themselves, if you will. We make sure they're taken care of. And that was a bill that has gotten more serious, that they call it patient dumping. You know, these are homeless people, they call them transients. We won't just take them and just leave them out on skid row somewhere. We are held accountable for the safe release of any of our patients. We give them taxi vouchers. The taxi has to come in and sign, and he has to have an address of where he's going. They can change it in the middle of the route, anything. This is where this patient is going.
Where do you work?
Oh, I'd rather not say.
Oh, okay. is it a hospital?
Yes.
Is it a mental?
No,
okay.
No.
It's just a hospital. Yeah. Okay. All right, so, but how would, so if you could tell me how you think, if this bill had been in place the night of Mitrice's arrest, you think things would have turned out
different? Oh man, I have visited that over and over so many times. I know her mother has visited that so many times over. And yes, without a doubt it would have made things different. Because her mother specifically stated, you can get a recording of the tape that says, if you're going to release my daughter, I will come out there and pick her up. They assured her that Mitrice was going to be released in the daylight time around around the Malibu Canyons. Her mother's distinctly said, because I don't want to wake up, headlines reading, head chopped off, asked about it. Subsequently, 11 months later, right to detail, and it was just horrifying. And why they were telling us, oh, she's okay, she's doing fine, you know, you don't have to worry about it. She had already been released. The last phone call was around 2 a.m., and that deputy was saying, and the tragic thing about it is, those jailers look at themselves as babysitters, because I asked, why would you do that? Why would you let someone out, a beautiful young woman, no purse, no cell phone, no money, no ID, no running transportation, out in the Malibu Canyons? And their response was, we're no profanity babysitting organization. That's terrible. That's just terrible. Mm-hmm.
So, what do you think about the bill? I know you said it's never too late, but I mean, do you think you wish it had been proposed sooner? I mean,
you would think that Baca would have been the Sheriff Lee Baca, and I'm so glad he's stepping down, and whether he wanted to do reserves or not, but you would think that after something that made this type of headlines, you would have been the first to say, you know what, we need to do this. This is just common sense. And I was often told by my director once that you cannot take for granted that everyone has common sense. A lot of police officers are overpaid security guards.